Journal of Food Chemistry, 2009, one of my favorite studies that I implement with every single patient coming to me to try and heal their body and prolong their life if they're battling cancer. And here is why. Anti-proliferative and antioxidant activities of common vegetables, a comparative study. In this study, this phenomenal study that should literally be a strategy that every single cancer patient, in reality, every single person wishing to never get a diagnosis of cancer, they should be looking at this study and implementing the dietary changes or dietary weapons, I like to call them, like garlic, broccoli, cabbage, curly cabbage, all these phenomenal vegetables. So what they did in this study, they literally took different cancer cell lines from stomach, breast, lung, medulloblastoma, glioblastoma, kidneys, prostate, pancreatic carcinoma. So we got pancreatic cancer, we got breast cancer up here. Let's take these cells, they put them in a petri dish, and then they took extracts from these common vegetables. I would love to see like dandelion leaf on this one. What about dandelion root? How phenomenal would that one be? I guarantee you, or I bet, maybe not guarantee, it would be better than even garlic. Oh man, would love to see that one in here. But these are the common ones. These are the ones that you might find on a salad bar if you go to, you know, the different places. I don't even know the names of them anymore, and I don't want to mention them because they're probably non-organic, but here we go. So this is a strategy. We should really, let's say, this is October right now. We got November coming up next. But you know what? Because that's the way the months go. They go from October to November. I just figured that out. But, you know. But we got breast cancer. All right, let's take breast cancer. So every single woman walking through the doors of their oncologist's office, they should literally, before they do anything else, they should say, really quickly, we want to go through a strategy you can implement on your own that could literally quadruple your survival rate. Yes, implementing nutritional and dietary changes can quadruple your survival rate, proven by the research. Watch one of my previous videos. All right, but in this one right here, look at this, breast. So let's go through the vegetables. If you are diagnosed or anyone you know has been diagnosed with cancer, they better have gotten this study. Otherwise, they're not going to the best oncologist they could go to. Or they need to find a practitioner or doctor like myself who's going to literally lay it out for them and encourage them to start seeking out these foods and eating these foods. Look at this. Garlic literally stopped proliferation. I mean, it stopped cancer cell growth. And in fact, reversed it and killed it. Leeks killed it. Green onions killed breast cancer cells. Brussels sprouts killed breast cancer cells. Cauliflower killed it. Cabbage significantly lowered it. Significantly lowered. Almost no cellular growth, proliferation in cancer cells. So you got to get those foods. So what I want to say is, why don't we take the women diagnosed with breast cancer and in these clinics, or whoever they're selecting to help them in healing their body, you know what? A strategy needs to be implemented in saying garlic, leek, green onions, Brussels sprouts, or cauliflower. We'll throw cabbage in there as well, broccoli in there as well. You know, you need to select from the top 10. So it's got to be kale, radish, broccoli, curly cabbage, cabbage, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts. And you got to get at least two of those in every single meal you eat. That's it. Two of those, at least, minimum. Eating a plant-based diet, but not just any old plant-based diet. You know what? How many garlic cloves have you ate today? How many leeks have you ate in this week? How many green onions have you ate today? You know what? I'm going to put it out there on my website very soon. And if you're watching this before I get it up, I apologize. But look up the Hippocrates soup. Hippocrates soup using the root of celery or a few celery stalks, using onions, garlic, using potatoes, using nutrient-dense anti-cancer foods was one of the number one things Hippocrates used to heal his patients. What if we said instead of potatoes and things like that, they're way up here for anti-cancer, we change Hippocrates' original soup recipe and we say, you know what, let's put cabbage, broccoli sprouts, not just broccoli, which broccoli sprouts are even better. And then we tons, all the garlic you can stand, all the leek you can stand, all the onions you can stand into this soup, and you eat that every single day to extend your life and beat cancer with food as medicine. I would love to see that happen. I would love this chart. And not just breast cancer patients, but every stomach cancer. I mean, look what all these foods did. So radishes, broccoli, cabbage, all of those killed stomach cancer. And what's phenomenal is if you can drop these extracts, you can drop these fruits or vegetables literally juiced onto cancer cells and they kill it. Well, what's phenomenal about stomach cancer then is this. If you're eating tons of garlic, that is coming in direct contact with those cancer cells in your digestive tract, and that will kill cancer. What about pancreatic cancer? What about prostate cancer? Is every single person being told the phenomenal benefits of leeks and garlic? Well, you got it now. So what I want you to do, just share this video. Make sure that people get this information in their hands, because God forbid they don't have one more tool in their toolbox to be able to beat cancer. Because you know what? I have spoke. It's literally been every single patient I have ever consulted. When they've been battling cancer, and I've asked, have you seen this study? Not a single one ever has seen it. And that breaks my heart, because we're sitting here since 2009 and we know the information that could literally save and change lives. Every cancer patient needs this study in their hands right now. Share this. Don't just like it, because sharing it is the only way we save lives.